First thing first, with our 1/8 plexiglass plate, is making sure that it is beveled nicely and evenly. So you can use sandpaper, two different grids. So you can start with 100 and you can finish with 320. But I prefer to use file, flat file, fine flat file. So this will be the first step in plate making. Beveling the edges, just be sure the edges are nicely beveled. And
when we talk about beveling the edges, you can combine two different angles. You can start with 45, then continue with 30. So that will create this nice smooth bevel, nice edge. So this is the right beveling, but this is not the right beveling. All right, let's start. The way we use our flat file is you are not going to use with a direct angle, which means you have to use your angle diagonally. So you will be using your file diagonally, not directly. And very close to the edges of your your table or work table. So the way we use our file, not with a direct angle, but diagonally. So this will prevent creating unintentional scratches, lines on the edge of your plate. And if we use our file directly, the direct angle, it will also jump your plate. It will vibrate it more compared to using our file diagonally. So as I mentioned earlier, start with 45 degree angle and count how many times you use your file on each edge. And just be careful not to hit the file. You have to prevent your left hand or right hand, whatever hand you use, to put pressure on the plate. It will be behind the file, not right here, because then you can hurt your hand. So just follow the file and count how many times you file each edge, each side. Usually I use 50 for each angle on each side of the plate. So 50 times here, 1, 2, 3, 50 times here, then change the angle, 45, 50 times, then rotate your plate 50 times, and 50 times, and repeat the same process for each side of your plate. So after we finish beveling our plate, now we can finally start drawing our first subject, which is an animal with fur or a bird. So I want you to display different qualities of line, and I believe the feather and fur is very helpful for you to emphasize different qualities, different values of your lines. So for this one, let's see, I will use a cat. Remember, whatever you create on your plate, you have to fill the entire plate, not a simple, small, tiny drawing, but I want you to fill the entire plate. Here, I will use just two pieces of masking plate just to be sure the drawing will stay intact. There are advantages of using epoxy. One is you don't have to transfer your drawing, so you can just trace over it.
So I want to make this a little more visible so I can see what is going on with my lines. To do that, you can use a pastel stick or charcoal. And I'm using browns. This is like umber. I may have some tones from this pastel. I think I will just have a proof print to see what I did. Looks good. So let's mark our reference drawing. So if we need to work on it more, we can continue from where we were right now. Okay, good. Printing time!